Hey guys, and welcome to a nice relaxing B&H photo, video, audio, catalogue, flip through. Since I ordered my camera that I'm using for this video, and its carry bag and some other accessories from B&H.com, an American-based gadgets store, basically. Basically, every 6 months, they send me their thick catalogue. And I've never really looked through one because I haven't really needed to. And I still don't, but I thought it would be nice to see what bits and bobs they had. And I had a quick look through, perused at my own leisure. I thought it was mainly photo, video and audio equipment, but they have game consoles and gadgets, as you can see, some drones, watches and stuff. So this is the winter 2017 catalogue. And let's have a look at what we can find. So we have the table of contents here. And as you can see, we have mobile technology, home entertainment, surveillance, computers, optics and outdoor gear, photography, lighting, AV presentation, camcorders, aerial imaging, professional video, audio for video, post-production, pro audio, used equipment, and that's an index. So we'll just take our time and flip along through, see what they've got. I'll probably skip areas that I'm not very much interested in, like some of this mobile stuff and TVs and stuff that you'll see later. We've got a lot of digital Walkmans and MP3 players. And I sort of hadn't really thought about it in a while that most people don't use their phones, or most people do use their phones that I know for their music. Especially iPhones and stuff. So it's weird that these things are still being produced. So there we go, got the smartphones and the all that. Galaxies. I get a little tired of having an iPhone sometimes just because they tend to crap out on me, but I can't really be bothered getting used to a whole new phone by getting an Android, even though there's a lot more freedom and I can program apps for it and stuff, whereas for Apple products you have to go through a long painful process. They're definitely not as developer friendly. So we've got a lot of accessories for mobile devices here, chargers, a remote for a camera, looks like a thick, fat guitar pick. Nothing particularly interesting here. What's this? Smartphone mount with wheels, righto. And there's those lighting things you can clip onto your phones. Honestly, you can get some pretty decent footage out of smartphones these days. I know a lot of ASMR artists use their phone mainly for their cameras, and it's perfectly acceptable, clear. Some portable speakers. I've always liked the wood looking ones, but I feel like they wouldn't last as long, they'd get scratched or, just not as sturdy. I do need a new pair of earphones. I like these ones, like not these particular ones, but this type that goes in your ear and cancels out the sound. I think the ones I have are a lot more like that. But it's been a couple of years, so they're pretty ready. Definitely need a new pair, but they're like $50, so might wait till Christmas or something. Some watches, Fitbits, smartwatches. A couple of digital voice recorders here. I wonder if they have the Zoom stuff. Or if it's just like name brand Sony and stuff. They got the Apple watches. We got some like lapel mics and stuff down here. That's pretty cool. I think they suit these digital recorders. Some portable DVD players. Yeah, some TVs that we're gonna skip because although I'm into technology and stuff, TVs just don't tickle my fancy really. I would actually love a projector, but A, they're quite expensive. Like this one's $10,000. And B, you don't usually get like a real crisp, clear projection. Like, it's obviously not going to be anything like watching it on a TV screen. But, yeah, like, I'd love to watch movies and play games that are projected onto, like, my wall, which is just pure white, so it'd be perfect for it, but maybe need a perfect, no, white would be easier, I would think. I was gonna say maybe you need a black wall, but either way, I'm not willing to pay 10 grand for a projection. Amazon Fire TV Gaming Edition on the Nvidia Shield. Some more like consoles, I guess, that I'm not interested in. Some record players. Sorry, turntable stereo system. Gotta be careful with those ones, because sometimes they don't actually play records. And it's like, well, what's the point in looking like one? Sound systems have always, like, bored me to death. My friend is a complete, like, audiophile. But I'm all about the visuals. Speakers. Looks like we're heading into the surveillance area, which might start to get interesting. What do we got? So we got some like alarm keypads. That one's good. What's that one got? Keypad and a key. Bit redundant. Some window and temperature sensors. I guess if someone breaks into your house and turns on the aircon, you'll know. Carbon monoxide alarm. Some security cameras. We used to sell these at my work, not these, like decent ones, like that one's $1,500 about. We sold fake ones and like low quality real ones, and it's like I wouldn't be spending $50 on a security camera. Like, is that how much you're willing to pay for your house's security? Go like a bit more expensive. Like this one's $205. That's a bit more reasonable. Of digital multimeters and tester sets for cables and that kind of thing. Here we got some security mics. And this thing is apparently a microphone. Just looks like a box. Looks like they sell all kinds of crap. Got some industrial lenses. I think they're for the different security cameras, I guess. Here we go. Pen cam. Elegant ballpoint pen with hidden camera. Capture video in 720p HD resolution. Shoot photos in 1600 by 1200 res. Record to 4 gigs of internal memory. Wristwatch with 720p covert camera. Spywatch. Wi-Fi micro hidden camera. Smoke detector with a hidden camera. Getting sneaky. Okay, we have some vehicle trackers. Didn't realize I actually sold that kind of thing. I've always been kind of against that. Like, I get if it's in your own car. But the only time I've ever seen vehicle trackers is in shows where there's like someone's up to no good, you know, like Breaking Bad. Walt's tracking his, what's he? He's trying to track Gus, or Walt's brother's trying to track Gus, and then like people tracking their wives and stuff. See, now we're in like the consoles and accessories. So I've got a bunch of different Xbox controllers here, and then some racing wheels. My friend wanted to get like a full-on racing wheel set with the pedals and stuff. I'm like, oh, I'm pretty sure there's better things you can spend your money on. No offense to people who use those, just him in particular could spend his money on better things. A tie pad for the controllers. Every now and then, I think, man, it would be good to have one of those. But I definitely don't send messages enough on Xbox to warrant buying a keypad for it. PlayStation VR for $400. Looks like they don't have any of the more mainstream VR things. It's just this Razer one and PlayStation VR, by the looks of it. Amiibos, apparently. Yep, they do indeed sell Amiibos. Some iPads. I've never seen, like, I've never understood the appeal of iPads. I guess if you like, just like the mobile games and stuff, they're good for playing those on, but I don't know, it's just like a giant iPhone, which I, you know, I've never wanted one, an iPad. I don't know, if I had one, I don't know what I'd do with it, really. My friend had one of these Surface Pros at uni, and I was like, ah, oh, that looks really good for uni, actually. And the difference between this and the iPad is that this one has, like, you can put programs on it that aren't on the Apple Store. And it has, like, keyboard, little fold-out thingy to stand it up. And yeah. So, like, I went to buy one after I saw how useful it was. And back then there was, like, the Surface, which anything you wanted to install on it had to be on the Windows Store. And the Surface Pro, which was like an extra grand, or like a grand and a half, and that one you could install anything on. But I was just like, you know what, I'll just get a different notebook, thanks. That, yeah, I was gonna say that would be super expensive. 16 gig RAM, 1 terabyte solid state drive, $2,700. There's no way I'd ever buy a Surface Pro with a 1 terabyte solid state. I don't even have a 1 terabyte solid state in my desktop. I think I've got a 512 because they just get too expensive. For that kind of money, you're better off just building a desktop and getting a cheaper laptop, you know. There's no way known you need a 1 terabyte solid state for a Surface Pro. That's ridiculous. Unless maybe do a lot of digital art or something on it, but holy cow, you must be rolling in it to buy that. And it's kind of the same with MacBooks. Like, stereotypically, people get MacBooks to edit and that kind of thing on, but they're really expensive, and I don't understand how they're better than just using a regular PC, you know? Unless it just renders faster or something. But I've never wanted a Mac computer. Nor an iPad, so I don't know. People who do want them obviously want them for specific reasons, but I don't know. I'm happy with my iPhone and my PC, you know. Gaming laptops. At least they're not selling Alienware. Oh, no, there's one there. Alienware laptops are typically way overpriced and way underpowered. So if you're going to buy a gaming laptop, first of all, consider just buying a desktop, because you can get a more powerful desktop for usually less money, if not the same amount. And second of all, consider not getting Alienware, because you're paying for the for the name more than the power. Got some nice carry bags. I've always been pretty partial to shoulder bags, actually. Take one to work with my drink bottle and wallet and my Apple. It's pretty ragged now. It's been a few years. What are these pre-built PCs? I get the appeal of buying like pre-built kits and stuff, but you get so much more customization and bang for your buck by picking out your own parts. The only downside is you have to put it together yourself or know someone who can do that. We've got some mini PCs. They're pretty interesting. And yeah, I was looking for that computer stick. It's like a whole computer on a stick that you just plug into a TV or a monitor. It's always been, the concept has been interesting. I don't think I'd ever use one though. When I got some webcams, I think I've got the non-E version of this one. The E is for like, I can't remember. Not even gonna pretend. But yeah. And I was gonna use it, if you remember, I did an unboxing video for that webcam. Because I was going to use it for an alternative solution to setting my camera up behind my desk at my other house. And never even used it once, so that was a good use of money. I'm hoping one day I have like a friend who's really into video calling or something, so I get my use out of my webcam. Windows. I don't think I've ever bought like just a Windows by itself. In saying that, yes I have. I bought Windows 8 for my computer. But like all the other computers I bought already had it on it. And in fact, when I bought my little netbook for our uni, the guy tried to sell me Office as well. I'm like, nah, that's alright, I'll just use like the free alternative ones or something. Turns out the laptop already had Office on it, so I'm glad I didn't buy it, because I would have had 2 copies. And that would have been the definition of useless. I really want to get some 144 Hz monitors, but the monitors I have now are like, it's either that one or that one. Let's have a look. Yeah, it's basically one of these ones are the ones I have. It's like the very thin frames around the border and capable of doing 1440p. That's the resolution I decided to run as opposed to 4K, which isn't really stable yet unless you put like two 1080 Ti's in your computer, which I didn't really want to do. But yeah, I really want to get some 144 Hz monitors because I've heard it's just so much smoother. My monitors are fully functional and I don't need to be throwing money away right now. Plus, the one game I would have used them for, I haven't really been playing lately, and it's nice to have a break from that game and play some ones for actual fun and not competitiveness. What do we got? Hard drives. They're not fun to look at. I have, let's see. I have a Crucial solid state drive in my gaming laptop. And I think I have a Samsung one in my desktop. Can't quite remember. I'm pretty sure I've got Kingston RAM if they do that. RAID arrays. Hard drive bay enclosures. Definitely need a new external hard drive. I have this one right here, and let me tell you, it's the most annoying goddamn thing. The cable is like so loose, so sometimes if I'm watching something on it, and like I put my foot on the floor after it's been like leaning on something, it'll disconnect, like it'll just wobble that little bit enough to disconnect. And yeah, it's just so annoying. I really have to get a new one. I do not trust the cable like at all. The problem is I have a 2 TB one, which is $80. So that's another cost, you know, yay. And I'm very reluctant to get a 4 TB one because I've heard once you start getting up there in the storage size, they become a bit more unreliable if you fill them up too much. I have a nice verbatim 64 GB memory stick actually, and I use that for uni. It's super useful, like having that much storage on something that's this big. That was a good investment, that one. CPUs and stuff. I have, let's see. The motherboard I have is this one here, I think. MSI 71. No, Z170A Gaming M5. I'm pretty sure that's the one I have. It's like the one thing that I knew the least about when it come to building my computer. $170. As far as motherboards go, it's okay. Coolers and stuff, power supplies, mid cases, cube cases, gaming cases. It'd be interesting to do a video on my computer build, but the problem is I'd have to have my computer unplugged and record to something else, and that's a huge effort. GTX 1060. I have a 980 Ti, and it's lasted me a fair while. It's going well. I put a fair bit of money in it because it was my first desktop, and I didn't want to upgrade for a long time. So naturally, I bought the 980 because that was what was out back then. And I think I had it in for like 2 weeks, and the 980 Ti came out, and I'm like, well, I'm already outdated. So I sold my 980 to my friend and paid the difference for a Ti for myself. And then he gave his old one to our other friend. Basically, we all like rotated graphics cards and like all got an upgrade basically. But I'm pretty happy with what I've got for now. It runs like everything that I currently want to play on the highest setting, so no need to upgrade. The only like reason I would potentially upgrade is because you can use your graphics cards to help render videos. So whereas these videos that I do would normally take like upwards of 3 hours, sometimes 8 to do without using my graphics card. If you set it to render using the graphics card, it cuts it down to like under an hour. And obviously, the more like powerful graphics card you have, the faster it's going to render. I don't need an Ethernet switch, but I do need a HDMI switch. These are those things that you plug into the PowerPoint and it gives you like Wi-Fi. Always seemed strange to me. We have a bunch of boring old people wired phones. It's just a joke. USB hubs I've always had a bit of trouble with. I had one that was like good and it broke. So I got another one and that just stopped working as well. But if you want a really good one, I think you have to like get one that plugs into the PowerPoint. But I've already got like a billion things plugged into the PowerPoint, so I don't need another thing to be plugged in. What the? I don't even know what that is. Oh, here we go. KVM switch. Switch between two dual-link DVR computers and USB. Oh, so that like swaps the entire system, righto. Something like that. Seems complicated. Scanners. They're no fun. 3D printers for $1,300. It's actually not bad. They'd be cool as to have. But I'd imagine the material that it uses would be mighty expensive and annoying to replenish all the time as well. 3D scanner for iPhone 6. See, like, I get the. How much was that? $500. It's almost the price of an iPhone. I get the, like, the desire to have all this mobile stuff, like scanners, mics that you plug into your phone, but if you're gonna spend that much on accessories for your phone, is it not better to go just all in and buy actual, you know, cameras and get the actual accessories for that kind of thing? because I don't think I would ever be happy, like, if I got that sort of in-between stuff. I'd have to go for the real thing, you know. Because, like, if I'm going to spend a lot of money, it's going to be something that is going to keep me happy for a long time, and not something I'm just settling for, you know. So I got some binoculars. A spotting scope. I thought it was like a, was it an eyeglass? A monocular? Here we go. Opera glasses. I did not realize they actually sold these. Opera glasses. You can get them in black, burgundy, green, or silver. I wonder if you can get like jewel encrusted ones. Just to be super, like, elitist. So we're starting to get to the camera stuff, which is actually interesting to me. I wonder if they'll have my camera. Wait, what am I saying? I bought it from there. Obviously they have my camera. But I wonder if they still have my camera. Alrighty. I don't think they have my exact one. I have a Panasonic Lumix GH4, but these are all DMC. I have like a really good memory card for it, because apparently you need them to keep up with 4K recording and stuff, which is what I record to, and then downscale to 1080. Because it would take me a week to upload a 4K video. But yeah, I had to buy like pretty expensive memory cards to be able to support that. Let's see if I can find it. I don't think it's here. Oh, actually it might be that one. SanDisk 64 gig. Because it has to be like a particular class and speed. I had this little one here, Wacom tablet, and then I realized that I can't draw on paper, let alone digitally, so I sold it on eBay. Lost a bit of money, but yeah, wasn't going to use it enough, and having it sort of just bummed me out, because it was a reminder of spending money that I didn't need to again, and having it go to waste. Which is a shame, because I would love to draw if I actually could. And I know that you get better by practicing and doing it and stuff. But I hate looking at my terrible work, so... I don't even understand what all this stuff is, you know. Just camera accessories, I guess, flashes, lenses. Some nice Nikon cameras. When I was buying one, a camera, I sort of had it between the GH4 and the Sony A7S, because the GH4 did 4K out of the box, but the A7S had way better low light setting, what's it called? Like it did way better in low lights, and it handled its high ISOs a lot better. Whereas if you put the ISO like too high on the GH4, it just gets really grainy, and it already is kind of grainy, but I don't want to put it any lower because these videos would be really dark. And I sort of didn't really think about the fact that I wouldn't be actually uploading in 4K. All I wanted was like top quality stuff, you know? I mean, I am recording in 4K, but like rendering and uploading. So in hindsight, I probably should have got the A7S. There it is there, actually. A7S. Really good for low light stuff, and I watched a YouTuber for like months before deciding what I wanted. And he did sort of a comparison between the A7S and the GH4. And that's sort of what I based my decision off, amongst other like reviews and stuff. I mean, I'm really happy with this camera. I use it a lot. Mainly for ASMR videos. And I don't like plan to buy this one and swap over or anything, because that would be wasteful. But I'm just saying, like, from the start, maybe I should have gone with the A7S. No, just things you think about, you know. I'm sure if I had have got the A7S, I'd be saying the exact same thing about maybe I should have got the GH4. Oh, there we go. That's my baby. DMC GH4. Says here the body by itself is 1500 and the kit with the interface unit, which is like, it's basically like a little platform that it sits on, and it enables you to plug in a bunch of other accessories. And it's definitely something that I don't need. I do need a new battery though, another battery. That'd be really good. And I don't have any particular need for new lenses at the moment, unless there's a wide angle lens somewhere. But I'd have to do research into it. I still watch that guy's camera video sometimes. He has a nice way of talking. He doesn't do ASMR, but they're just relaxing and informative, and it's good stuff to like just chuck on while I'm dozing in bed before I get up, you know. Just got all the, like the lens adapters and stuff. I'd be very careful about using lens adapters. There's a reason that lenses aren't only suited for their particular camera. And if you get a cheap and nasty lens adapter, you're likely to damage everything involved. Wonder if they'll have my bag in here that I have. Lens filters would be good. I really should take this camera out and do some actual photography with it. But I've never known what to take photos of, you know? And I've always just thought my photos were stupid. But like, I like the idea of like UV light, UV filters and that kind of thing. And my friend has like a Canon, I can't think of the model. It's a bit of an older one, but it's still good. And he takes amazing like, night sky shots, like just deep purples and bright twinkling stars. They are beautiful. And I have the means to do that, but not the know-how nor the patience, probably. What are these? Lighting flash things, like diffusers and stuff. Polaroid cameras have always been interesting to me because, like, I would love to use one, but we just talked about how my photos are rubbish, and these ones run out of film, and the film is super expensive for film to replace. So, no thanks. I know when I shouldn't buy things. Now, anyway. tripod and monopod from here, I believe. One of these. I have a Benro monopod, which is what I'm using now. It's pinned between the wall and my desk, because I get a better angle. And then for like roleplay videos and the car driving one, I use a Manfrotto tripod, which maybe I didn't get that from here. Oh no, yeah, Manfrotto. Oh no, I didn't get the tripod from here. I got the tripod from my local electronics store, actually. Some heads for the tripods and monopods, and some fashionable camera bags. Right, if I see my bag, I'll point it out to you. Alright, it is rugged. But it's not on this page, I don't think. Actually have to use the bag as a counterweight. There it is. That one, the Rugged Commando 25. It says it holds a small DSLR with kit lens, and that's pretty much exactly true. I get my camera in there, I get the lens in there detached, I get the battery charger, a couple of cables, and the memory discs, memory cards. Could be a little bit bigger, just like it's $20. I was like, oh, that's really good. Could be a little bit bigger if I wanted to be more comfortable with the camera, but I didn't want to go too big and then have it be too much room, you know. But I actually do use the bag as a counterweight to keep this mic arm up, because the microphone's a bit heavier than the arm can handle, apparently. I really do need some lights. My friend got a big old light box like this, because he got into doing motion capturing for his animations, which didn't turn out, but he got some really nice box lights. And that would definitely help, I think. Softbox, that's what it's called. They light things quite nicely, but they take up a lot of room. So like, the softbox obviously wouldn't help in a video such as this one, where I'm just using my lamp. I'll tell you what I would absolutely love though, and I kinda gotta save up for one. It should be coming up here somewhere. Aside from a couple of softboxes. These are only the heads, I think. See, like, I just want the whole kit to be done with it, you know. I don't want to have to buy the stand, and then the light, and then the globes, which are massive. Just send me the complete light, you know. Holding wax. I guess that's for propping things up. See, all these accessories are interesting. Pro Photo Studio Kit. It's got like a little cage that you put things in. A little studio here for models. Interesting. Definitely don't need any umbrellas. We're not doing professional photography here. Is what I want. I really want a green screen. Because even though I don't like use the background a lot behind me, I'd much rather have like just pure black behind me. So I don't know how like a black curtain behind me would go. It'd probably look like there's a black curtain behind me. But if I got like a green screen and then, you know, digitally made the green to pure black, that might look a lot better, and like it would hide all the things in the back of my room that I don't need, and make role plays a lot more believable. I could superimpose images on it. How much was that set thing? Manfrotto one is $271. Impact is $105. Seems to be 3 feet wider than the Manfrotto one though. So I hope that doesn't speak to the quality. Looks like I'm saving up for a Manfrotto background support system. 271. It's like 1 week of work, but it's not really saving up if I just spend that whole week's pay. And I also have to factor in shipping, which would be a fair bit to Australia, because it usually is. Laser presenters and projection screens. We have some camcorders. I actually had a cheap, nasty camcorder that I bought a couple years ago for filming music videos. Not like music videos, but for like filming me playing music. Shotgun mic. Kinda need one of those. Maybe. I have a billion mics, I should stop buying mics. And I was not happy with the quality that the camcorder was giving me. Everything was really fuzzy. Which is why I bought the lovely Lumix GH4. Easy VHS to DVD. Captures VHS videos to Mac. Just what I've always wanted. GoPros. Most of my friends have a GoPro. I don't go outside enough to warrant the need for one. My GoPro footage would be like me going down the street to buy food. And then it looks like we're coming to the drones. My dad loves drones and all kinds of like remote flying things. He's bought at least 3 different remote control helicopters. But they take ages to charge and you fly it for about 30 minutes and then have to charge it for like 8 hours. It's ridiculous. I've always liked these ones, like the quadcopters. we actually sell a few at work for like under $100, I'm pretty sure, usually. And they even have cameras in them. But they're in the toy section, and I can't imagine that drawings for under $100 do too well in the range or like video quality department. Like, bloody hell, they've got a gimbal stabilized 4K camera on a drone here for $1,200. Again, that's one of those things that would be cool to have, but I wouldn't know what to do with it if I had one. Looks like we have some... What is this? Oh, do these... These goggles look like they attach to your phone or whatever, and get the footage from your drones. That's trippy. That made me feel sick using that. Oh look, Pokemon Go, remember when that was popular? Never really got into that. There's the Gear VR. That's the only like non-Oculus or what's the other one? There's like two main VR headsets, and the Gear VR I think is the Vive. The Gear VR is probably the only non-Vive, non-Oculus VR headset that I would consider purchasing. Some professional video. So everything here is going to be super expensive. Like this is $5,500. 4.6K digital cinema camera. I wonder if any ASMR artists use these like massive like cinematic cameras. That'd be cool. We'd have like a range from people using phones up to people using full-on movie quality cameras. I doubt it doesn't seem what's the word I'm trying to think of, like doesn't seem worth it money wise. These are something that I am actually interested in, because I would love to have a little monitor that plugs into the camera, and I can sit it here and I can see what it's properly focused on, because a few times I've filmed a whole video and then realized I was out of focus the entire time, so that wasn't fun. But, well, for starters, that one's $3,000, that one's $1,000. Looks like this one's only like $200 to $500. Ideally I'd go with a brand that I know, so like Sony or not Panasonic, because that's $3,000. Yeah, I guess my only option would be the Sony one at $700. Yay. Oh, here we go. Got some Zoom stuff now. Zoom H6, that's what I've got. And I've used it twice, I think. Had the right results. I think I need to be a bit closer or possibly get a stereo shotgun mic for that. Just so that it focuses more on me and less on the room it's in. walkie-talkies, I think, or radios. You can call them radios if you want, but they're just glorified walkie-talkies. Pinnacle Studio, we used to use that back in the day to record our PlayStation, like, Call of Duty gameplay, when my friends and I all had dreams of running YouTube channels. Magic Bullet. This would be an awesome software that I'd totally buy, but for some reason it lags the absolute hell out of my computer, which is supposed to be like a god computer. Like, I don't understand what I could possibly cram into that thing more to make it not lag running Magic Bullet. There we go, the Dazzle. That's actually what we used to record our PlayStations back before Elgato was like a well-known thing. And yeah, it was not great because for some reason I could only do 1080i videos, which means there were scan lines all over it. It's very annoying. These are all capture cards that you can use for gaming and stuff. And yeah, there's like external ones like this. And there's ones that go like directly in your computer, and then you plug whatever it is into your computer. But I just have an Elgato HD, what is it, a Game Capture HD. That was like $200, does the job. Yeah, and the Dazzle's a bit more budget friendly at a mere $50. But I don't think it does HDMI, I think it was only like the colored cables, which was annoying. Well, ranting aside, that was a nice flip through the B&H.com winter 2017 catalogue. I think out of all the things I talked about, the one thing I actually have to probably save up for is a green screen of some kind. If I had that, I think I'd have everything that I pretty much need for this whole ASMR video project. There's not really a lot else I could think of that I need. Maybe that stereo shotgun mic. But I usually make do with what I have. But I'd like to thank you for joining me. For this ramble and flip through. Hopefully it was nice and relaxing and it helps you guys sleep. I hope to see you in the next video.